The ATEM Television Studio HD8 ISO model has a pretty unique feature that lets you stream from a Blackmagic device across your local or worldwide internet into the ATEM and pick it up just like a physical source that's connected directly to the box. I've got the HD8 ISO here on the desk, and I also have the Blackmagic Studio 6K Pro camera to test out the whole setup and show you how it works. We'll walk through the setup on the local network here, but with some port forwarding setup on your own router, the same applies for streaming somewhere else in the world directly into the ATEM. I have the ATEM here powered up and connected to my local network over Ethernet, and I also have the studio camera powered up and connected just via the network cable to my local network. Next, I'll want to configure some things in the ATEM software control to make this all work. In the ATEM software control, I can go to my settings, into my sources, and then in this remote source setup option, I'll want to add my new remote sources. Then at the bottom, I can add a new source and give it a name to help identify what it is. I'll just call it the Studio Camera 6K and leave all the rest of the details as they are. Note here at the bottom, we have a red warning about the internet status, port forwarding error, and I also have my worldwide IP and the worldwide port. Since we're just going to stream over my local network here, I don't actually need it to have access to the worldwide internet, and I don't need to make any changes there to make that work. However, to make my life a little bit easier, I will change this worldwide IP to the IP address of my ATEM switcher. Here on the ATEM control panel, I can go into Home, Network, and tab over and see the IP address of the switcher. You can't quite read it there, but it's 192.168.140.3. So I can enter that into my ATEM software control here, 192.168.140.3. The reason I'm changing that here is because we're about to export an XML file and import that into our camera, and it's going to be a little bit easier just to change it here instead of opening the XML file and editing it manually on my end. With that done, I can choose this little export option here, a little button, and it'll save that file. It's called the Studio Camera 6K right now. That's perfectly fine. I'll save that. I've just dropped that XML file onto this USB storage here, and I can connect this up to my camera for the next step. With that USB pen connected to the camera, I can go into my settings here, and in the setup menu, I'll find some streaming settings. Now, I could go live to YouTube or Facebook or something from here, but I actually want to import my own settings. So I'll go over one, hit import settings, and you can see my XML file that I added to the drive is just popped up here, and I can import that one into the camera. Successfully imported. Go back to the platforms here, and now I have this ATEM Television Studio HD8 ISO as a destination. I'll hit stream, and it'll start going live on that ATEM. If I head back out of the menu here, you can see that we are going live, and there is a little status indication saying how long we've been live for and how much data it's pushing to the ATEM. Now keep in mind here, you can use that XML file on other Blackmagic equipment like the ATEM Mini Pro, ATEM SDI, ATEM Extreme, all the ones that have streaming capabilities, and the web presenters as well. But it won't work on other RTMP devices that are not from Blackmagic design. There is some stuff baked in for the streaming encoding that only their products will work with this setup. Unfortunately, I would like to see that improved in the future and opened up to other encoders, but for now, it'll have to be a Blackmagic design encoder sending that signal into the ATEM. So looking at the multi-view on my ATEM Television Studio HD8 ISO, you can see, well, I don't have any sources coming in just yet. Even though I'm streaming from that camera to the ATEM, it's not popping up just yet. And that's because we need one more change in the ATEM software control to make it work. And that one change I want to make is here in the sources tab. I want to change it from an SDI source to the streaming source here that we called Studio Camera 6K before. I can hit that and choose save as well. And now back over on my multi-view, you can see a camera has popped up, and that is camera one, the streaming source. If I move the camera around a little, you can see it's coming in, looking good and working as a streaming source. You can also see that the ATEM is sending back information to the camera. So as I cut around on the ATEM, you can see it goes from program to preview. I can also make adjustments to the camera in terms of the color, the shading, the focus as well, all via this remote connection. I've just connected this other Blackmagic camera directly up to my ATEM switcher so that I can compare the latency between a direct connection versus the streaming connection over network. So on the multi-view here, you can see on the top left, I have my streaming source connected. That's this one. And on the other side, the top right, I have my SDI source connected. And I'll just zoom in a little bit closer so we can see a better view of the timers. And I'll give this a pause after the fact and see what the difference is in terms of latency. Now, of course, you will see a difference between the two, and that's understandable. The connections are coming into the ATEM in a very different way, but it's up to you to see if that's usable for you. Here, right side by side, it wouldn't really make much sense, but if this camera was somewhere else in the building connected via the network, it would certainly make sense, especially if I brought some audio in via this connection as well. Keep it in sync that way, and then I can cut to a studio that's somewhere else in the building, and this will be a lovely use case for that. Conditions are pretty perfect here in the office, so I can connect things up and it works nicely. If you want to do this a different way, worldwide or over 4G and 5G out in the field, things might work a little bit differently for you. That said, the basic setup is the same, where you'll configure things in the ATEM software control, set it up for the ATEM to accept incoming videos, and then start a stream from your camera wherever in the world you are. Port forwarding is something you'll set up in your router, and it's a little bit different on each one. You'll want to check your manual just to see how that works for your specific one, and then you can open up the port and stream into the building, or ask maybe the network administrator to do that for you instead if it's something you're not familiar with. So is this something that you would use in your productions, whether that be remotely, worldwide, or within a building? Instead of having to run a long SDI cable, you could just use this network that's already in your walls probably to get a signal from one side into the ATEM. I can see it working very nicely for those sorts of situations. If you have any questions about this stuff, do let me know in the comments below. Otherwise, I guess I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.